Good morning, guys. It's Days with Jordan the Lion. How are you today? Hope you're having a great day already. I'm up a little early. It's about 7 a.m. right now, and I have a pretty peculiar day. Somebody who watches my show works for a company, and their company hired me to go to a private event today and privately vlog that event for them. So I can't give it to you guys. I can't even show it to you guys. But I just thought that was a pretty cool opportunity, and I was pretty flattered by it. And they basically just said, hey, it's a private event, but we love what you do, and we would love to have like an inner office, like something that our company owns that's you vlogging our event. And so I'm going to get paid a little bit of money to go do that today. And as soon as I get done, then I'm going to go hit Echo Park Lake. And man, there was a lot of stuff filmed out there. And it's got quite a history. I mean, Echo Park goes back to the 1800s, so this ought to be a pretty cool day. John and I were up watching some early morning YouTubes, drinking some coffee, and as soon as I went to get my shower, he tucked himself back into the bed, so I don't know when you're going to get to see him. That pile right there is him. Well, look who popped his head out. Good morning, friend. You want to go outside before I get going? You do? You want to go outside too? You do. Okay.
Don't blame me. I voted for Willie Nelson. Classic.
All right, guys. I will see you when I'm done. Then it'll be off to Echo Park. What's funny is that I'm at the convention center, which a lot of people don't know. When you see the airport used on a TV show or something, it's usually this convention center lobby right here. That's usually what they use for an airport. So now it looks like things may have changed. It looks like they may let me use some of this footage for my own vlog, just as kind of a promotional thing, but I'm still gonna make them their own vlog, so could be cool. All right, guys, so I can vlog in here before the event starts and show you guys that. But other than that, that's it. All the vlogging I'm gonna be doing for this event is on my camera. And that's all gonna be their footage. Well, today I decided to come out to Echo Park, the Echo Park Lake, and I figured, you know, since I was just talking about it yesterday for the Mac Senate vlog, I figured I should just come out and do it today because I've actually been meaning to do it for a while. It has quite a few stories, it was using quite a few things, and heck, why not? Especially right on fresh on the heels of the Mac Senate stuff. Now, I did not used to come here because this used to be a very shady place to be. This used to be a lot of drug selling activity. This park lake used to be a lot of homeless people sleeping everywhere. Less families to enjoy the park is now. And basically how they cleaned that up was all of a sudden in my opinion, they kind of fudged it, but they said that the waters had become so polluted and so contaminated that they needed to drain the lake, or yeah, basically drain the lake, drain the pond, and they were going to thus get rid of everybody from the entire area. They basically lined off the entire park with police tape, and you weren't allowed to trespass during that time. And that kind of helped rid the area of the people they were trying to help get rid of. But this has been used in movies and various things, like I told you. One of which, you might recognize the little bridge over there in the background. Let me see if I can't find a good way to show you that. But you would have seen a scene from the movie Chinatown, and you would have seen Jack Nicholson out there on one of those little foot paddle boats, those little pontooners. And you would have seen that bridge in the background over there.
Now, what they also use this for is that little space right ahead of us. They would do some of the scenes from Gilligan's Island in the first season out here on this little lake lagoon thingy. I don't see anybody walking across the bridge, which makes me think that it might be closed off. But I'm here, so we're gonna go take a look. And like I was telling you in the video yesterday, you know, being that Max Sennett started Keystone Productions out here, and all of his scenery was Edendale, just about everything that included water from his time at Sennett Studios, other than the very first one, the Water Nymph, I watched that the other night, and I could clearly tell that was not done out here. And when I looked into it, they are reporting that it was filmed in Venice, which makes more sense because there's actually a ship in the background of one of the shots. But anything else water-related, they would have filmed out here. And I was actually able to find some footage of one of the sections on the other side of there of where they did a small little segment of a Charlie Chaplin flick with Sennett Productions out here with Mabel Normand. So let's go take a walk around and see if we can't get over to that bridge and get over to the Gilligan's Island Lagoon area. Here's a little bit of the story here. You can kind of see, I don't know how much the sunlight's getting in the way, but you can kind of see picturesque right there, 1910s. That was actually from one of the movies. And you can see the lake right there in the middle of what would have been Edendale at the time. Echo Lake was designed in 1892. And one of the interesting things is that I found was one of when they first started making movies out here in 1913, it actually started in 1912, but in 1913 they drained this lake for some other reason. And Max Sennett took advantage of that and came out and filmed something with Mabel Normand right on the lake bed floor. I guess they mean the ducks.
Wah, 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 wah.
I actually had a date out here one time, and the girl I came on the date with said that she came out here at least once a week and would feed the ducks. And that was in the heyday before they were... before they had drained this thing and got everybody out of here, so you can imagine how what I thought of that. I thought it was pretty cool, but I was like, she's had to have beaten up people before. She's had to have been in a knife fight before. She had to have been. They have a Miss Lotus Festival out here. And they're also doing some headshots out here. I know it was filmed in Chicago, but as I'm walking through this little walkway area and I'm seeing all this stuff, for some reason it's making me think of Dr. Detroit when Clifford Scridlow is doing his power walk by the water and has that headband on with the little side mirrors. Classic. I don't know what made me think of that, but since I thought it, and I'm out here alone, you guys have to hear my stupid thoughts. Oh, that's cool. This guy brought his girlfriend out for like a little Valentine's Day picnic. Or it's a photo shoot because he's taking a lot of photos. Could be a Valentine's Day photo shoot for next year. I wonder if that makes me, considered negative because my mind immediately went to that. I'm like, oh, he's taking pictures of her with a good camera. Must be trying to make money off the event. Now, let's see what this is. Queen of the Angels, known as Lady of the Lake. Interesting. We made it over there, and this is the little section they said that they would use for Gilligan's Island for the lagoon shots and stuff. And I found that in numerous different places, so I tend to believe that it's probably true. And there's the bridge you would have seen in the background of Jack Nicholson in Chinatown. when he's floating along with that big grin on his face in the boat. My suspicions seem to be correct. I see a gate right in front of the bridge, so it doesn't look like they allow you onto the bridge. But I'll walk around the lake anyway. Access denied. And I can totally see how they could have done a few shots. How would they have gotten the houses out of the way, though? Because there's a little island right here. I guess you could have filmed some stuff there, but... Look at that purple flower. You could have filmed some stuff there, but... I think you would have seen the houses. I just about got attacked by all those birds. I turn around, there was just about 800 of them flying towards me. Like a Hitchcock movie. Lots of retired people come out here and play checkers and chess and backgammon and all those games. As my grandpa would call it, they're loafing. Okay, well, I seem to have answered my own question. Well, I hear a drone right above me, but this kind of, I guess I could see how they could have done Gilligan's Island shots right here. If you would have tightened up the shot and not got that... That building probably wouldn't have been there anyway, but I could see they could have done some shots there. Ooh, there's a lighthouse. Let's go take a look at the lighthouse. There's the lighthouse. The lighthouse and the boat rental. One and the same. Last time I was here, I saw a homeless guy taking a bath in one of those, right up there in one of those sinks. That's pretty cool. I think we can probably call it a day on Echo Park Lake here. I still have to walk around the other side. I mean, I'm probably 3/4 of the way around, but I think you guys have pretty much seen it all. And here's from the westernmost part of the lake. Just to give you some depth for where we're at. This must be the lotus blossoms. Look, more stairs! And even more stairs! Oh. Except these stairs have a mural of either marathon runners, maybe from the Olympics, or is that Burt Reynolds? I really can't tell. Who the hell abandoned methanol out here? It's not attached to anything. Unreal. Why do I get the feeling that methanol is going to be in the news in a few days? They used to call these Hoovervilles. After Herbert Hoover. And these are definitely Hoovervilles. Not to be confused with Hooterville from Green Acres. All right, look at the sky. I guess technically I've done two vlogs today. And I have two vlogs to go edit, so... Catch up with you guys after I pop in and see my little four-legged friend. It's gonna be hopping around waiting to see me, and I get some stuff edited for our vlog. One you get to see and one you don't. Didn't miss me one bit, did ya? Did you miss me at all? You didn't miss me one bit, did ya? Did you miss me? Did you miss me? Did you miss his hand? Hi, Jaw. Hi, Jaw. I got some mail. I had to order a new pop socket because I use mine so much on the back of my phone to steady the phone and stuff that I actually have worn it out and that it's actually falling off. And I ordered this about 2 weeks ago, anticipating that I might have this issue. In the last 3 days, I've been really fighting it to keep it on there, so... But look at what the cool, awesome one that I got is. Nice. I got to bring home my lunch from the event today. And it's a Bentos box. Doesn't that look good?
Well, guys, I got an email, and I already have the link for my headshots that I took the other day. She took about 100 photos. And told me to pick out 6 that I liked, and she would tweak them and, you know, perfect them and whatnot. So, very unlike me. Normally, I would immediately look at them and look all over them and pick the ones I liked and everything. This time, I actually didn't do that. This time, I actually forwarded the link straight to my agent, and I just said, hey, can you look at these and tell me which ones you want? And he got back to me and said these three would be great, and you pick the other three. So now I'm going to go look at them and see if what I would pick are the same three out of six that he would pick. Well, the first three pictures in that whole little slideshow were the three that my agent liked, and the ones after were the ones that I liked. I'm pretty happy. I like the photos that she took. I think she did a good job, and you can only be you. You know what I mean? Like, as much as there are little things that I wish I could change, it's me, and that's all I can be is me when I go in for an audition. So, hope you guys enjoyed that weird day. I can't even, you know what's weird is I can't even tell you what it was that I vlogged that I showed you earlier today. I'm not even allowed to tell you that. All I can do is just show you a little bit. But if I told you, it would be even weirder and even funnier. So I'm sorry that I'm not allowed to say anything, but I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I hope you enjoyed that long trip around Echo Park and me constantly mentioning that island being the Gilligan's Island Island because, you know, I know they keep reporting that, but I keep looking at it and I just keep wondering, How is that possible? How is that possible? But anyway, tomorrow will be another great day. Thanks for coming and watching my vlogs. I am completely without words to thank you guys for how much you watch my videos and how many emails and comments I get during the day. I never thought I'd be saying this, but I'm getting to the point where I feel like I can't respond to all of them. Like, I feel like I miss some, and I do want to try and acknowledge everybody and respond to everybody, and if you have a question, I try and answer it. So I'm really sorry if I happen to miss you. It's not intentional, and I do really try and keep up with everybody if I can. I do care about what you guys are up to and what you have to say, so just wanted to let you know. Thanks for watching my vlog. I will see you guys tomorrow. I don't have to work tomorrow, but I have a pretty fun trip planned. And, yeah, until then, have a great night. All you people that are sending me messages saying that you bought peppermint soap, see, I told you. I was right, wasn't I? You love it. And to Jody, who bought the Esther Price based on my recommendation, I'm glad you did. You're one of the few that will get to experience the beautiful joy that is Dayton, Ohio chocolate. So until tomorrow, I'll see you guys then. Have a great night from Hollywood, California. Your old pal Jordan and your old pal sniffing and snorting down there while he's drinking Jaw. We say goodnight and have a great one.